Let's move on to the tricks. So first trick is that first start with route planning question, please. I'm going to show you the pictures of the exam, how is it going to be look like. You can see the number 1 2 3 4 5 6. So when you're going to go to the exam, this is going to be the number 1 2 3 4 till is going to be about 31 32, because 25 is going to be A to Z. Then 5 or 6 is going to be route planning question. So you're going to see the number like this. When you're going to click on the number 1, then the first question is going to be appear. So first 23 question is going to be from the book. So you're going to skip that question. You can skip it, means you're going to click number 7, 8, 9, 10, and you're going to go to the number 24. Now when you go to, when you're going to go to the number 24, the picture is going to be look like this. Like this. So you can see, so this is going to be the first route planning question, and the number is going to be written at the bottom as well. So you must do these route planning question first. So when you're going to click start, so you're going to draw the route, then you must click stop drawing as well, guys. So the first trick, please skip A to Z question and do route planning first. So it's going to be 5 or 6 questions. Try to finish in 1 hour 20 minutes. If you did planning, means if you did practice with someone, then you're going to finish about 50 to 1 hour. Then you're going to have 1 hour to do the A to Z. So finish A to Z in 30 to 40 minutes. Then come back to your question, then check again. So the first trick is that first please start with the route planning question, do A to Z later, because your mind is going to be fresh. This question is easy. When you do the, when you do A to Z first, then you're going to tired, then because this A to Z is going to be 25 marks and route planning is 75 marks and the passing marks in 60. So if you do only route planning correctly, you can get maybe 70, then you're gonna pass. And if you do A to Z, you're gonna spend 1 hour, because this is hard to find the answer. But if you do training and practice a lot, then A to Z is gonna be good as well. I mean, you can finish in time. So first trick, first start with the route planning question. Now the second trick is gonna, so second trick, when you're gonna do the route planning, so please you're gonna read the question. On the left hand side, you can see the draw the most direct route from Chelsea embankment green marker to the Battersea Road red marker. So must read the question, because one or two question is going to become where you say road is closed. So this question is did not mention it here. So but when you're gonna do real exam, the one question will come that road is closed. So please read the question and do not use the road which is closed. So this is going to be the second trick, because if you use the closed road, if that question is 15 marks, you're gonna get 0 marks in that question. So the second trick is use read the question carefully, guys. Thank you so much. Now we're gonna move to the trick three. Okay guys, trick three, if you're doing the question first time, 100% you're gonna get the tunnels. Is going to be mostly two tunnels comes, rather Rotherhithe tunnels and the Blackwall tunnel. So this is the higher marks, means one question is going to be 15 marks, and this is going to be, if it is two question, it's going to be 30 marks. So when you get the tunnels, so make sure you watch my videos about the tunnels and you're doing the right turns. When you're going into the tunnel, you're using tunnel approach, means when you're coming from the left hand side, you're going to want to go into the tunnel, you make sure you're doing the right turn into the tunnel. And if you do little mistake over here, means if you do like this, and you're gonna get 0 marks. So make sure when you're gonna get the tunnel, you are doing the right entry into the tunnel. You're gonna use tunnel approach. Like this is a Rotherhithe tunnel. A lot of people, they coming from the Limehouse link, they just go into the tunnel like this. And this is going to be 0 marks, because we did not use tunnel approach. So the tunnel approach is over here. So the better you come from here and use tunnel approach. You can see this tunnel approach. So use tunnel approach to go into the tunnel, because this is very, very important. So if you're not going to use tunnel approach, you're going to get 0 marks straight away. They're not going to check if you're right or wrong from the beginning and the start. If this is wrong, you're going to get 0 marks straight away. So this was a trick. Let's move to the other trick. So the other trick is that if I want to show you the question, the question says, look, if you read the question, draw the most direct route. So what's the meaning of direct route? If you find the meaning of direct route in the dictionary, the meaning is straight line, means it's a straight. So a lot of people, they say, oh, we are doing minicab more than 10 years, 15 years. They then go to the exam and they fail. And they use the main route that they think, oh, this is the most direct route. But the most direct route, as we know, the meaning of direct is straight line. So like these questions, how, so we're going to get a lot of people, they do like this. I'm going to draw roughly, don't worry about that. They just use the main route. And they just finish the question like this, but this, they're gonna lose 10 marks. They're gonna get 5 marks out of 15. So the most direct route, if I see this one, look, you can see over here, this road is going like this, and this, look, you can see this is a big valley is coming outside, and because of that they lose too many marks. So direct means we have to get the straight line as much as we can get it. But in some question, maybe because of tunnels, because of river, you can't get it, but you can get the straight line and most direct route from point to point. You can watch this, my video. The video is called most direct route. If you write in the YouTube most direct route TFL, then you're gonna find that video. I'm gonna show you how. As if you just go in the YouTube and write most direct route TFL, it will comes up. So the first video is mine. If you open this video, then I explain properly and briefly and with example what's the meaning of most direct route. Please watch this video if you want to understand more. Yeah, so this trick was that try to find the straight line, try to get the straight line when you're gonna start draw the line from green to red. It's not about the fastest route, it's not about the main routes. Please try to understand. I'm just teaching more than a year, and I did the exam as well, and my passing rate is 100%, as when the people go and they tell me as well. So with this experience you learn, because the TFL is not telling you how you're gonna pass it. This is with experience when the people go and they do the test and they apply this thing, they're gonna get more than, they are getting more than 90 marks, and they're telling me as well. Okay guys, I hope so you understand this one. And the last trick is that, so please do some training of this route planning question. Other book question is very easy, you no need to do training and spend money on that. So please do some training this route map with someone or with me. If you come to me, or then you can sit home and do training. I have a very good packages. Means I have the question about these 300 questions. You can see these are the folders, and you can, if you open this mixed route folder, you can see there's a lot of question I make it, and I gathered from my students who did the exam and they just told me. So you're gonna come into this laptop and you can practice as many as you can for 10 days, for 15 days. I have different packages. And then you can save the question, as you can see the name over here on the right hand side. People, they are doing it and they save the question. Then I can mark it for you and I will give you feedback. So do some training. I know, because you saw my videos. A lot of people watch my videos, they pass, but these are the only 2%. I can give you the example. Means if we, someone is driving and you're sitting on the passenger seat, if you're looking at the driver, how he's driving is different. When you're gonna have a steering and the gear and the pedal, then it's going to be different. When you start driving, then it's going to be totally different. So it looks easy when I do the maps on my videos, but when you're going to do by yourself, it's totally different, guys. So do some, minimum 6 hours you should do training. This one, you have to draw the routes with your hand, with your mouse, then you're going to get some sense, and you're going to understand it. Thank you guys. If you like this video, please give me thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, because I put videos more often. And please follow these tricks and do some training, and then you will be success in your test. I will give you the guarantee, guys. Thank you so much.